shot 68 at Bulls Bay, and it was I had six birdies and two bogeys, and it was a day I'll never forget. I'll never forget. I have four hole-in-ones. Got one last week or a week before. Yeah, in Tennessee. I hit this little 9-iron from about 138 was the number. Like, I don't know. I know exactly what I did, but I hit it. It's 9-iron from 138, and I hit the green, and my buddies were like, well, that could be close. And we just watched it drop. It was nice. It was nice. Oh, hot dog, always. I mean, if I get a, you know, perfect snack to eat at a turn at any golf course is a hot dog. And the one thing we've discovered is some courses have some really good hot dogs, and then some courses have some really bad hot dogs. But yeah, hot dog is perfect at the turn. I listen to a lot of sports talk radio. I mean, I like to listen to sports talk radio just because, you know, so usually right now I'm Golic and Wingo just because, or the Dan Patrick Show, whichever's playing when I'm driving there. Oh, the 5-foot putt is definitely more intimidating than going out to a show because I've been doing the shows forever. But like, you know, that 5-footer is not just the money because you don't care about the money. It's the fact that you're going to get to brag until you play again, you know. So that 5-footer, a little knee knocker. Oh my goodness, great question. Other than Charleston, my favorite city I've ever visited, Amsterdam. I mean, with all the history and everything that's there, I mean, I'll never forget the first time I walked into the Van Gogh Museum and lost my mind. You know, I'll never forget the first time I walked into the Anne Frank House and just started bawling. You know, I mean, Amsterdam's got a lot of history and I really like going there. Pro golfer I'd most like to play with that I haven't played with, I mean, I love Patrick Reed and I love Dustin. I played with Dustin though, but I think the guy right now that I think I would have a blast playing with is Ricky Fowler. Ricky and I we get along, he makes me laugh, he's so cool and so funny. I'd like to go out and see if I could take some money from Ricky. Great question. Oh, the last person to make me starstruck by far, and I mean I was like a little girl, was Paul McCartney. I was like, I swear to you, my kids turned to me and said, Dad, are you about to cry? It was, yeah, McCartney freaked me out. Best food in Charleston is this restaurant downtown called Fig. It stands for Food is Good. And they have this dish that's ricotta gnocchi and bouillabaisse, and it's like eating clouds. It's unbelievable. It's my best meal probably in the world, my favorite meal in the world.